Hello everyone, today I'm going to show you my level 150 build using Serpent Bone Blade that focus on the use of double slash and charge attack power to inject poison build up to the enemy. Serpent Bone Blade is a katana that scale primary with strength and dexterity. This weapon has weapon skill called double slash. With this skill you can perform a crushing slash attack from a low stance, delivering a powerful diagonal slash in quick succession. By repeatedly pressing the skill button, you can unleash up to 2 follow-up attack. So wearing Rotten Wing Sword Insignia Talisman is recommended to increase its attack power. What I like about this weapon, it fast and can inject poison build up to the enemy. I also like the charge attack animation for this weapon. It's pretty cool and feel impactful. However, this weapon has a short range, cannot be infused with Ash of War, buff with magic and consumable. Also, using the skill and charge attack consume a moderate amount of stamina, so investing Enoch Endurance in your status is recommended, and consume Pickle Turtleneck also helpful to increase your stamina recovery speed. Overall, what I like the most about this weapon besides the poison effect is the coolest charge attack, a very good weapon for dexterity build to inject poison build up to the enemies. Before we start, a big shout out to today's sponsor, Elden Ring Checklist. Are you feeling overwhelmed by the fast world of Elden Ring? If yes, then this checklist can help you to stay organized and on top of everything you need to do, from collecting weapon, completing achievement, or keep track for all bosses in Elden Ring. It's easy to use checkbox in PDF file, you can print and track your progress offline, also it's a good way to support my channel. Download Elden Ring checklist today, link in the description below. So let's get started. Serpent Bone Blade is a reward from Tanith after completing the second letter quest in Volcano Manor. For weapon we have Serpent Bone Blade Finger Shield, Scale Armor Set to give me good poise and protection, Dragon Crest Great Shield, X Talisman, Dagger Talisman, and Kindred of Root Exculturation to raise attack power when poisoning occurs in the vicinity. I also have Opaline Heart Tear, Thorny Character Tear, and Pickle Turtleneck to boost my stamina recovery speed. For level 150 build, I put 40 in Vigor, 14 in Mind, 32 in Endurance, 11 in Strength, 82 in Dexterity as my main attribute, 30 in Faith for Black Flame Protection Incantation requirement, and there is no change in Intelligence and Arcane. As always, I like to cast Black Flame Protection and Golden Vow Incantation for my buffs.
Destined death. Yeah.
mark of a true lord. Oh, dear Mikola. Oh, dearest Mikola, my brother. I'm sorry. I finally met my match.
For more Elden Ring video, don't forget to like this video and hit subscribe button.